sailors and airmen of the Allied Expeditionary Force.
You are about to embark upon the great crusade toward which we have striven these many months. The eyes of the world are upon you. The hopes and prayers of liberty-loving people everywhere march with you. In company with our brave allies and brothers in arms on other fronts, you will bring about the destruction of the German war machine, the elimination of Nazi tyranny over the oppressed peoples of Europe, and security for ourselves in a free world. Your task will not be an easy one. Your enemy is well-trained, well-equipped, and battle-hardened. He will fight savagely. But this is the year 1944. Much has happened since the Nazi triumphs of 1940-41. The United Nations have inflicted upon the Germans great defeats in open battle, man to man. Our air offensive has seriously reduced their strength in the air and their capacity to wage war on the ground. Our home fronts have given us an overwhelming superiority in weapons and munitions of war, and placed at our disposal great reserves of trained fighting men. The tide has turned. The free men of the world are marching together to victory. I have full confidence in your courage, devotion to duty, and skill in battle. We will accept nothing less than full victory. Good luck, and let us all beseech the blessing of Almighty God upon this great and noble undertaking.
Kowalski, Ward, Carter, hold here and watch the road for German reinforcements. Corporal Taylor, you're with me.
Let's get that roadblock set up!
Taylor, here they are. We found the damn guns. Get in there and fix them with your thermite grenades. I'll keep an eye open for crowd patrols. I'll take the ones on this side.
Ah!
worry about!
Six calling Sugar Charlie 6. Located Point du Hoc. Mission accomplished. Need ammunition and reinforcements. Many casualties. Over.
Thank you.
Charlie's still here!
Hey, Gary, catch this! Stick with me!
Edge of the cliffs, shooting down at them with machine guns and throwing grenades. And the American Rangers began to climb. They shot rope ladders over the face of these cliffs and began to pull themselves up. When one Ranger fell, another would take his place. When one rope was cut, a Ranger would grab another and begin his climb again. They climbed, shot back, and held their footing. Soon, one by one, the Rangers pulled themselves over the top. And in seizing the firm land at the top of these cliffs, they began to seize back the continent of Europe. 225 came here. After 2 days of fighting, only 90 could still bear arms. These are the boys of Puente Hope.
Sounds like we've got screaming memes up ahead, but I couldn't make visual contact. I did spot an 88 on the other side of the hedgerow. Expect a crew of at least two and a couple of MG-42s. So what's the plan, Sarge? I need runners with suppressing fire. Garcia, Hawkins, take the left with Rossetti and Jones. The rest will follow me up the right flank. I want grenades on them as soon as we're in range. Brayburn, McCloskey, and Taylor, you stay back and provide a base of fire. Keep those Krauts off us so we can move in. All right, move up. Wait for my signal.
Thank you. Taylor. Pack your bags. We're moving in.
Infantry in the open! Out front!
Get his horse! Track him! We gotta shoot!
This house is clear! Move on to the next one! Corporal Taylor, climb that silo with Braeburn and McCloskey and watch for an enemy counterattack. Everyone else, take up positions around the perimeter and stay sharp.
Respect, sir! I don't think we're gonna last that long! Over!
work, everyone. Make sure your sectors are well covered and we'll meet back here in an hour. Dismissed.